Hello there, Esteban here from Gohitsu Shota Studio. In this video, I'm going to show you how to prepare a brand new brush. So you buy a new brush, there's a couple things that you need to know. And one thing that you're going to notice right away is that the hairs are hard. This is because they're covered with this wax coating and that's keeping it hard, and this is to protect it. You don't want to wash this off right away. You want to do that a little later. What you want to do right away is going to tie up a piece of string around the hair where the handle and the hairs meet.
Not necessarily. And I actually don't do this anymore. A long time ago, I made this video. When was this video published? 9 years ago. So 9 years ago, when I made this video, I explained that the first thing that you need to do when you get a brand new brush is to tie a piece of string or a sewing thread around with a little bit of glue around the heel of the brush. And you would do that for a couple of reasons. And the reasons that I gave on the video are actually still pretty valid. And is that the string will help, one, prevent the hair from coming off eventually, which tend to happen to a lot of brushes, and also to create a little bit of tension at the heel of the brush. And then that tension also help the brush maintain a tip and be a little more bouncy on the paper and just easier to use. For years, I did that to a lot of my brushes. I mean, I have a box full of old brushes and a lot of them are tied up. This one is tied up. Even the big ones, okay, I got big ones that I tie. You know, I did that to a lot of my brushes. I mean, there's gotta be at least 100, you know, some of them I didn't even use. I never used this brush and it is tied. And I did this for a lot of years. The thing is that I'm much better at calligraphy now than I was 10 years ago. So I actually don't do this anymore. I don't tie my brushes anymore. So what made me change was when I went to Japan in 2018, I met the master brush maker from Toyohashi Fude, Yamasaki Kanohiro. And when I visited them, they showed me how they make brushes, the process, the craft of making these brushes by hand, and the effort and the love and everything. Was just a great experience learning how they make these brushes by hand. I asked them about it. I asked them, do you recommend tying the heel of the brush with a string, and does that help? And his reaction was like, oh, no, don't do that to any of my brushes. And I mean, and I asked, what do you mean? Why not? And the short answer was that his brushes were very, very well made. The hairs are not gonna fall off because of the way he made them. The blend of hairs that he chose for the brushes were very meticulously chosen and blended and put together in a very precise way so that the brush will behave the exact same way he wanted it to behave for the calligrapher. So there was no need to tie any string to create any tension, to help him make the tip, to help the bristles from coming out, none of that. Like, the brushes just absolutely did not need any of it. In fact, if I were gonna do that to his brushes, I would actually be damaging the brush and making it behave differently than what was intended. Eventually, what I ended up learning was that not a lot of people actually do not do that. I learned how to do that from my first calligraphy teacher. She was the one who taught me how to do that, and they told me the reasons to do it. Well, what I didn't know is that the reason why we were doing that, because we were using cheap brushes from like Daiso Japan, you know, which is like the dollar store. And these brushes are like really cheap and really crappy and really crappy. And they have like, you know, they're not very well made. So yeah, we needed to tie the heels of, we need to tie the heel of the brush because it would actually help the brush perform better. But once you got your hands on a good quality brush, then you do not want to do that because it doesn't need it. And it actually may make the brush behave differently or poorly when he has those, when he has the heel string attached. So that is really the basics of it. If you have crappy, cheap brushes, then yeah, tying the heel will actually help. But if you get yourself a good quality brush, as you should, if you're taking calligraphy practice or shodo seriously, then you do not have to do that. It's just not necessarily anymore. So that's it. I just wanted to make this video to kind of clarify this point, because I've gotten a lot of questions about it, and some people will actually be like, oh, because in the video I also say to do that before you actually use the brush for the first time. And I've had some people say, oh, I bought a brand new brush and I forgot to do that, and they think they kind of screw it up. So you don't really screw up your brush at all. Actually, you might actually screw your brush if you tie it, if you actually bought a good quality brush. So I just wanted to clarify that from this old video that I made a long time ago. And this is a testament that you keep learning and then you keep changing as you get better. And then I'm much better at calligraphy now, 9 years later. My writing is a lot better, and my understanding of good versus poor quality brushes is a lot better. So I don't really need to do that anymore. So that's it. That's for this video. I just want to explain why I don't tie up my brushes anymore. I'm just using better quality brushes, and you just don't need to do that if you have a good quality brush. If you're interested in Japanese calligraphy and want to learn the basics, I have the Shodo 6-week introductory online course. I'm working on version 2, which will be available in spring of 2023. For more information, click the link in the description down below. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.